Majesty will deliver the Peace Declaration to the world. The copies of the declaration will be sent to the heads of all UN member states and to the local governing bodies in Japan. The declaration will also be sent out throughout the internet to all corners of the world.
Nagasaki
Peace Declaration. Close your eyes and listen. While thousands of arms and legs were torn off, intestines drooping out, maggots swarming in bodies, those still breathing searched for loved ones and cremated the dead they found.The smoke of burning corpses rose into the sky, and innocent blood stained the water of Urakami River. Leaving only keloid scars, the war finally came to an end. But my mother and father are gone.My brothers and sisters will never return. People are weak and quick to forget. They repeat the same mistakes again and again. But this one thing must never be forgotten. This one thing must never be repeated under any circumstances whatsoever.This poem was written by a woman exposed to the Nagasaki atomic bombing at 11:02 a.m. August 9, 1945. 17 years old, she lost her family and suffered serious injuries. The poem expresses her fervent belief that no one else in the world should never have to experience the same tragedy.The atomic bombs were built by human hands and exploded over human heads. It follows that nuclear weapons can be eliminated by an act of human will, and that the source of that will is, without question, the mind of each human being. The present world situation involving nuclear weapons is extremely dangerous.The opinion that nuclear weapons are useful is once again gaining traction. The United States is developing smaller, more manageable nuclear weapons, and Russia has announced the development and deployment of new nuclear weaponry. Moreover, the Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces, INF, treaty that ended the Cold War arms race is facing dissolution, just as the continuation of the Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty, the New START, is imperiled. The achievements of humankind and the results of our long-standing efforts to rid the world of nuclear weapons are collapsing one after another, and the danger of a nuclear calamity is mounting.Have the desperate appeals of the atomic bomb survivors endeavoring to ensure that the living hell caused by the nuclear weapons is never repeated fail to reach the ears of the world? The answer is no. There are many people in the United Nations, in governments and municipalities, and especially in civil society groups, including the atomic bomb survivors, who share the same opinion and are speaking out.As a collection of small voices, civil society groups have shown the power, time and again, to change the world. The testing of hydrogen bombs in the Bikini Atoll in 1954 stirred up a wave of protest that swept across the globe and resulted in the conclusion of test ban treaties. Similarly, The power of citizens' movements played an important role in the conclusion of the Treaty on the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons in 2017. The power of a single individual is small, but by no means weak. I call out to civil society throughout the world. Let us continue to discuss our experiences of war and the atomic bombings and pass the information on future generations. Knowledge of the horror of war is an important first step to peace. Let us continue to promote trust between people across country borders. The bridges of trust built by individuals will help to prevent the outbreak of war due to the national conflict. Let us inform our children about the importance of understanding the pain of others that will sow the seeds of peace in children's hearts. There are many things that we can do in the cause of peace. Let us avoid despair and indifference and continue to cultivate a culture of peace. Let us raise our voices and insist that nuclear weapons are unnecessary. This is the big role that all of us can play, however small we may seem. Leaders of the world, visit the atomic bombed cities and see, hear and feel what happened under the mushroom cloud. Imprint in your mind the inhumanity of nuclear weapons. Leaders of the nuclear states, the Treaty on the Non-Proliferation of Nuclear Weapons, NPT, will reach its 50-year milestone next year. All the nuclear states should recall the meaning of the treaty, which promises to eliminate nuclear weapons and compels each country to fulfill that duty. I appeal to the United States and Russia in particular to assume responsibility as nuclear superpowers by demonstrating to the world concrete ways to drastically reduce nuclear stockpiles. I also appeal to the Japanese government. Japan has turned its back on the Treaty on the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. As the only country in the world to have experienced the devastation caused by nuclear weapons, Japan must sign and ratify the Treaty on the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons as soon as possible. As a means to that end, I ask Japan to seize the trend towards denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula and to initiate efforts to make Northeast Asia a nuclear-free zone where all countries coexist under, not a nuclear umbrella, but a non-nuclear umbrella. And above all, I ask the Japanese government to uphold the spirit of never resort to war enshrined in the Japanese Constitution and to take the lead in disseminating that spirit around the world. The average age of the atomic bomb survivors has exceeded 82. I ask the Japanese government to adopt further measures to support the aging survivors and take steps to assist the people who were exposed to the atomic bombing but are not yet to be recognized as survivors. As a city exposed to nuclear devastation, Nagasaki will continue to support the people of Fukushima who are still struggling with radioactive contamination 8 years after the nuclear power plant disaster. My heartfelt thoughts go out to people who perished in the atomic bombing, and I declare Nagasaki's determination, along with Hiroshima and people everywhere committed to peace, to strive relentlessly for the abolition of nuclear weapons and the realization of the lasting world peace. Tomohisa Taue, Mayor of Nagasaki, August 9, 2019.
Pledge for Peace.
Mr. Yoshiro Yamawaki, representing the Hibakusha, will deliver the Pledge for Peace.
平和への誓い。
Pledge for Peace. On August of 1945, the United States of America dropped atomic bomb on the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, which took the lives of over 200,000 people. At that time, I was 11 years old and was exposed to the atomic bomb at home, approximately 2 kilometers away from the hypocenter. My mother and four of my younger siblings had evacuated to Saga, so fortunately they survived. But my father was working in a factory 500 meters from the hypocenter and died in the explosion. My older brother, younger brother, and I, the three of us, gathered any remaining unburned pieces of wood and cremated our father's body near the remains of the burned factory. However, we could not bear to stare at his burning remains and left there while looking at the blazing fires. The following day, we went to collect his ashes, but his body had not burned all the way through. Only parts of his limbs had burned completely to ash. Let's at least just take his skull and go home, my older brother said to me. When he touched part of the skull with the hibashi or special chopsticks for collecting bones in cremation, it broke in a manner similar to plaster and the cloudy and partially burnt brain started to leak out. My brother shrieked and dropped the hibashi and ran away. I followed after him. We left our father's remains in that dreadful state. The crematorium were all destroyed in the bombing, so many others also had to go through similarly cruel experiences with their lost family members and relatives. Not only that, but those who had narrowly survived had to continue living while suffering from their injuries from the heat rays and the after effects of the radiation exposure. About 20 years after I was exposed to atomic bomb, I developed acute hepatitis and nephritis, and I continue to receive treatment for these conditions to this day. Nearly 60 years after, I developed stomach cancer, and in 2008 and 2010, I underwent surgery to remove the cancerous tissue. My older brother and younger brother, who were with me at that time when we cremated our father, also developed cancer and are continuing to receive treatment. It has been 74 years since then, and we, the Hibakusha, the survivors of the tragedy, have been continuing to appeal for the abolition of nuclear weapons alongside many people. I also started self-studying English when I was over 60 years ago, and in November of 2015, at the PAGWASH conference in Nagasaki, I asked the scientists of the world in English to lend me their strength to make nuclear abolition a reality. However, it is said that Russia, America, and many other countries around the world still collectively possesses a total of 13,880 nuclear warheads. Furthermore, America has announced their withdrawal from the Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty with Russia. And in February, it was reported that the Trump administration conducted their second subcritical nuclear test. These actions betray the wishes of all people praying for nuclear abolition. With each passing day, the Hibakusha are becoming fewer in number. I have a request to make at this ceremony for Prime Minister Shinzo Abe here today. As the only country in the world to have suffered from atomic bombing, I humbly ask you to appeal to all of the nuclear weapon states to eliminate their nuclear stockpiles while the Hibakusha are still with us. On this issue alone, Japan must not follow America and show their firm stance of nuclear abolition in all fields related to nuclear weapons. I will, of course, continue to appeal for the abolition of nuclear weapons until I die. This is how we should honor the 200,000 people who lost their lives in Hiroshima and Nagasaki 74 years ago, and the Hibakusha who continue to live while suffering from the after effects. I sincerely sincerely hope that Japan, having sacrificed the lives of over 3.1 million people in World War II, will preserve its pacifist constitution established after the war and will fulfill its role as a leader in realizing a world without war or nuclear weapons.
Please lend us your strength to eliminate nuclear weapons from the face of the earth and make sure that Nagasaki is the last place on earth to suffer an atomic bombing. Thank you. 2019年平成元年
吉野山脇
被爆者代表山脇吉野
August 9th 2019